Well, I'm the president of the NASUWT, the largest teachers organisation in the United Kingdom, and the members of the Gibraltar Teachers Association are all members of NASUWT. And I've come out here to find out what the issues are for Gibraltar teachers, and I've had a fascinating 2 days. Well, the Gibraltar branch is like any of our branches. It has plays a full part in the union. It's able to send motions to conference and direct and our policies, but we're also interested in providing support for the particular circumstances that Gibraltar teachers find themselves in here, which are different from the mainland. Well, I think one of the most important is the geography of Gibraltar, just the very fact that there is so little space on the island for schools to exist in, and therefore the amount of play area for children is clearly something which teachers have to cope with, and the school buildings tend to be quite tightly packed, but that's inevitable given the geography of Gibraltar. Well, we've visited both the Director of Education and this morning the Chief Minister, and we've discussed some of the issues around how we can help support Gibraltar in raising standards of education for children here. It's clearly something that teachers want to do. They want to get the very best for the children of Gibraltar, and obviously the politicians do too, so we are both on the same side of the argument there. The question is how can they help us to raise those standards by providing the sorts of facilities that are necessary to enable that to happen. I think Gibraltar has managed to avoid some of the worst excesses of the changes that have happened in the United Kingdom. I think the fact that it keeps the family of schools together here in Gibraltar in a way which does not promote unhealthy competition. Now, competition is not necessarily unhealthy, but certainly in the United Kingdom it's become that. I think that that's something that you should value and protect so that all children get an equal standard of education rather than the sort of cutthroat competition that we have in the United Kingdom, which has led to some very unfortunate circumstances in some schools. Well, I think one of them has been recently an underinvestment in education. The tightening of school budgets to the point where it is no longer possible to provide children with all the necessary books and equipment. I don't see that here in Gibraltar, and I think the commitment that we have seen and which I heard from the Chief Minister this morning is to try and keep Gibraltar at the forefront of education developments. And he was talking today about initiatives with ICT, which if he's able to find the resources for them would be a huge step forward for pupils and teachers here in Gibraltar. Okay.